I hope that the two-day conference will be beneficial, will be productive, and valuable takeaways that can be used for your future endeavors.
Again, my sincerest thanks to Moxie and Berry Enterprise Management Sdn. Berhad for giving me the opportunity to chair this inaugural conference.
It's a very important issue from the hardware aspect of it and also from the software aspect of it.
In aviation, safety and security is the number one priority, just like you guys in oil and gas.
In fact, in my organization, when it comes to safety, it's not negotiable, it's non-negotiable.
The existing work process is not robust enough to codify the lessons learned.
So it's part of your overall safety, you will utilize electrical stuffs.
Starting simple, taking the first step will initiate a very strong system.
Make it 100%, make it 100%, not 80%, but you know, the other 20%, whether they're sure or not sure on how.
So we come up with a memo to ensure that all the enhancement is implemented at our operation.
The environment has not changed, but what has changed is in people's minds, society. Society has developed and we're becoming more and more demanding.
Let us not be scared of high risk. When we have red on our risk assessments, it's an opportunity for improvement.
If you really, really wanted to, you can manage all your assets, explosion risk, anytime, anywhere.
We need to accelerate in order for us to get the value from our operation and also safety and health.
Operational excellence is around efficiency. That's entirely what it is.
We have given a commitment and we are very conscious about it, so there's a lot of actions revolving.
I think what we've just seen, especially in the last 4 years, is that we've gone back to what is comfortable, fast and easy, and not what is right.
You know, it's about culture. If it's not ingrained in our culture, if it's not built into our culture, how do we progress with making safety a priority?
Am I right to say that we are actually insecure?
So basically, all of our mobile communication is insecure.
The targets for hackers were actually the banks. There were enterprises, there were banks, there were insurance companies.
As I mentioned also initially, ransomware is still something that we should be very much aware of and take the proper measures.
And to achieve zero incidents, we initiate a gap analysis, and there is four foundation pillars were found.
So we always try to reduce and minimize the percentage of moisture and water and the gas.
We find that in many areas it is typically the number one, number two, or number three highest category of incidents in our region.
You can do A and B and C correctly, but the sequence should be C, B, A, and you do it A, B, C, that's bound to be having a lot of accidents.
Because all the accidents are preventable. Because if you don't do the risk assessment effectively, the worker do not know what are the risks that they are facing.
What I'll be covering today is a disruptive technology that we acquired a couple years ago.
Get someone neutral, a safe space where you can go and express without being judged.
Individual, how as a company, how as a system, approaches the fire safety management in a holistic view.
In the oil and gas industry, we cannot run away from the fact that we are dealing with very hazardous material.
It was amazing journey to capture and bring all the speakers under one roof. I thank all of my group and also Secretariat of MOCSEC. Thank you very much for your support. Thank you, Malaysia, and thank you all.